I'm Stefan Simonon, working at ABN AMRO, and I'm going to share the CSD story with you. So I will tell about why did we start it, what did we achieve, how did we implement our pipelines. I will give some best practices, some do's and don'ts. I will depict the way forward, and then I will also elaborate more about our Jenkins journey and our public cloud journey. I'm heading CV Software Development. That's a group of specialists taking care of software quality and application security. Our responsibility is to make sure that the right tools are in place for our development community, and we're also taking care of cloud native development. So about ABN AMRO, we are a Dutch bank, third largest Dutch bank. We have about 22,000 internal employees. In total, we have 60,000 employees. We are headquartered in Amsterdam, and we are a full agile organization. We have 300 to 350 agile teams within ABN AMRO. So what were the challenges we were facing in the past? We used to be a waterfall organization. This was 4 or 5 years ago. It took long time to start up projects, to execute projects. All kinds of documents need to be made, all kinds of approvals need to be given, all kinds of handovers need to be done. And once we checked how long would it take design and implement an Hello World application, and if we would follow all the processes, it would take 5 to 6 months. So in the meantime, we see that more and more fintech companies are popping up. Fintech companies also getting into banking products. We see our competitors speeding up. So we said we need to do something. And we already had started the agile transition. We already had started a cloud transformation. We also we already had started the software oriented architecture program. But we said that's not enough. We need to fully automate our software delivery. We decided to do to start a CSD initiative. And as I said, we used to be a waterfall organization. Within the waterfall organization, more and more agile teams popped up. We transformed into a full agile organization. We ended a reorganization last year. So all the people, they need to apply for their position. And during the selection process, an agile mindset was very important. The selection was done based upon the agile mindset capabilities. And the people who did not have the capabilities were not selected, or the people which were not committed to this, they also had a choice to apply or not. So if they did choose not to apply, and if they were to be dismissed, they got a package to leave. In the meantime, we started a CSD initiative. I think that was 3 to 4 years ago. And now we are slightly moving to a DevOps organization. So we have more and more DevOps in the meantime, and we continue to improve over time. So what did we do to start up the CSD program? We defined 2 tracks. The paved way is all about the tools, about the infrastructure, all the technical capabilities, so all the pipelines. So every technical facility which was required was taken care of in the Pave the Way program. And the second initiative was about Make It Happen. And Make It Happen is all about mindset and behavior, simplifying processes, making sure that there is a change way of working. Make It Happen is about 70 to 80% of the journey, because our belief is that the cultural change is much more difficult and much more important than the tooling itself. So we started 3 to 4 years a pilot with 5 or 6 teams which were eager to improve. We defined a small pipeline, a CI pipeline, based upon Jenkins, based upon Bitbucket, based upon Nexus, based upon SonarQube. The 5 teams, they started to work with the pipeline. There were tremendous benefits. People got happy because people also want to work with the best-in-class tools. We demoed the benefits to the senior management. We got the teams involved also in the demo. And then the senior management said, okay, very impressive. We need to roll this out across the whole organization. So we onboarded more and more front-end Java teams. The pipelines, they got more mature. At some point of time, we extended technologies. So we have Microsoft, Siebel, BPM TIBCO. So more and more, for more and more technologies, we got the pipelines in place. Teams got more mature in the system test environment. And after getting more mature in system test, we started with the CD, with the continuous delivery. So we got the right tools in place there. We got also their pipelines in place. And our goal is to enable the teams to do full automated production deployments. And the goal is that we can enable production, automated production deployments from a commit of a developer. So meaning continuous deployment. So this is the toolset we have in place for mid-range, for Java front-end. We have Confluence, Jira, Slack in place for collaboration. We grew from 2,000 Jira users to 11,000 now. In the beginning, we encountered some performance issues, some stability issues, which was mainly caused by a lack of standard way of working in Jira. Every team was defining their own Jira best practices. So we said we need to standardize. So we implement a standard way of working. We moved Jira to AWS, and now Jira is very stable up and running. We use Jenkins for CI orchestration. We use XL release for CD orchestration. And within CI, we also have the code quality implemented. We have SonarQube for code quality. We have Nexus Lifecycle for open source management, the tool of Sonatype. And we have Fortify for secure coding. I will tell later more about this. We use Nexus repository to store the deployable artifacts. And the output of CI, the output of continuous integration, is a deployable artifact in Nexus, which will be picked up by XL release. And the XL release will take care of the CD orchestration. So XL release will trigger the change management process. They will trigger the functional testing. They will trigger the deployments, which we do via XL deploy. For commercial off-the-shelf, we are implementing Ansible now. And we also have ServiceNow integrated and Splunk and AppDynamics. Splunk for application monitoring, for application logging, and AppDynamics for application monitoring. And also the incident management process that's getting integrated in our CI/CD pipelines. For testing, we use the HP tools, HP ALM, HP UFT. We see more and more shift left in testing. People are more and more using open source tools, which we find okay. And we're checking also whether we can obtain a better solution for testing, because we see that HP is not able to improve their tools according to our needs. So these are the pipelines we have in ABN AMRO. I just showed you the front end, the Java pipeline. But we have similar pipelines for mobile, for PowerCenter ETL. It's a data warehouse environment. BPM TIBCO, very important. We also have mainframe within the bank, big mainframes. We're also making a mainframe pipeline based on Compuware toolset. And also there, we are implementing Jenkins in our CI pipelines. And for Microsoft, we're using VSTS, Visual Studio Team Services. So, as I said, software quality, secure coding, very important. We have done lots of awareness sessions to increase the awareness on secure coding, security, and code quality. We have implemented the right tools so that the programmers can check their code quality in an early stage. We also have the first facilities enabled to give them the code quality tools in their IDE. So if they want, they should use it. But we saw also that although they have the right tools, although they get the feedback, although they get the warnings, there was too much. Too many times we saw that the issues were ignored and they just implemented business functionality without proper code quality. So we decided to implement a set of build breakers, code quality gates. And this means if the code quality is not good, if the code is not secure, if the open sources are vulnerable, then Jenkins will block the build. The build will fail. And the programmers are, they need to fix the issue before being able to continue. And because of this, we saw some issues in the beginning, some escalations, but our senior management supported us. And over time, we see that programmers started improving their software and also making their software more secure. So this is a very best practice to implement code quality gates, quality gates and build breakers in the early stage of the pipeline. To support all this, to make sure that we keep on improving the tool sets, keep on improving our pipelines, we have an IT for IT organization set up. That's also consisting of DevOps teams. As IT for IT, we want to eat our own dog food. So several teams are set up to do the upgrades, to improve the tooling pipelines, to resolve incidents, to help agile teams to handle user requests. We have, for example, a software logistics team, the solo team, which takes care of Jenkins. They will do the Jenkins upgrades. They will install new Jenkins facilities. We have a mainframe modernization team. We also have a CSD metrics team, which is rolling out CSD metrics. Because as somebody was mentioning early stage, if you don't measure, you cannot manage. You cannot take decisions in a proper way. And very important is also the pipelines team in the middle. This team makes and maintains standard pipelines, which are offered to the agile teams. And they do not do this in isolation. We have an inner sourcing model within ABN AMRO. So all kind of communities are set up. We call it triangles within ABN AMRO. And within these communities, Java developers, Microsoft developers, they come together, they share knowledge, and they come with requirements, intuitions for all kind of pipelines. And this pipeline team, they will take the requirements from the development community, and the product owner of these teams prioritizes what's going first and what's going next. Very important to have such kind of IT for IT department in place, because we want to enable, we want to make sure that developers spend their time on developing code and delivering software and doing all kind of tooling maintenance. Therefore, we have the IT for IT organization. So what are the benefits so far? We have lots of benefits. Test environments are more stable. We have improved quality, improved time to market. For example, mobile banking, internet banking, they used to have 4 releases per year in the waterfall environment. Here it's mentioned now 18 releases per year, but now they're deploying on a weekly basis and they want to move to deployment per 2 days. We see a private banking team which decreased their build time from 5 hours to 5 minutes because of Jenkins automation. We see a team which doubled their velocity because of investing 1 sprint in only CSD improvements. So 2 weeks only doing CSD improvements led to a double velocity. We see teams, a few teams which are already doing continuous deployment. So automated deployment to production via commit from a developer team. And we see good improvements in our release management process. You see within our bank, probably also within other companies, that people get fast in delivering software, but releasing the software still takes lots of time because of the change management process, because of all kind of manual things which are required. So very important in CSD is also, if you want to do continuous deployment, that you do refactoring. We have many monoliths from the past, and in order yeah, if you want to be quick, you need to refactor the monoliths and you need to decompose them into small applications. Those kind of things are now also organized within ABNIO. So what are the takeaways? Senior management commitment, very important. They need to provide the budgets. They need to help solving big impediments where needed. Right? And they need to spread the message towards all the teams. So it's very important that they take the podium and they stimulate the teams, the organization, to invest in DevOps and CI/CD. Invest in reducing technical debt, crucial. I just told the story about the monoliths and the decomposition. This is required in order to do continuous deployment. And very important is also to create a safe environment in which failing is okay. Let the teams experiment. Let them fail. Let them learn from the failures. And do not punish them if they fail. So in the past, in the waterfall area, we used to have service levels with our suppliers. And if they did not meet the service levels, they had a risk to get a penalty. So we removed that. And instead of giving penalties, we now rewarding teams if they learn and if they share their best practices. So what is the way forward? As I said, we further transform to DevOps. We continue to automate and improve the tooling pipelines, also from a security point of view. We keep on working on improving the way of working and the mindset. So DevOps, CI/CD, it's not something you do from one day to other day. It's a continuous improvement activity. It's all about getting better day by day. I will tell more about facilitate increased team autonomy later and the role of Jenkins in it. Also, I will elaborate upon our hybrid cloud strategy. We're doing a proof concept for database automation. So we have invested a lot in the pipelines for delivering software, but making database changes, still a weak spot within ABNIO, many manual activities in it. We're going to do a proof concept with DB Maestro. And as I said, we are making CI/CD metrics to enable decision making based upon real data. So what is the current Jenkins environment? We have cloud-based Jenkins platform implemented in our on-premise environment. We have 70 VMs and still growing. I think we have 10 masters, more than 80 slaves, 128 connectors, and we have about 1,500 developers. So the environment is quite stable. I'm very happy with the environment. But the disadvantages, if there is a master stuck or if there is a plugin required for a team or if a team has a certain need, they need to go to the central team and based upon the priority, it can take some time before implementing that. So what we do in order to further scale, in order to facilitate team autonomy, we need to move from a centralized maintenance to a decentralized maintenance. We need to do automated scaling. So if you need an additional master now, all kind of manual activities are required to get that master and to implement that master. We have automated some things, but still manual activities, which lead to all kind of conflicts in tools. And we want to move from static VMs to Docker containers. So we procured CloudBees Jenkins Enterprise in the beginning of this year. With CloudBees Jenkins Enterprise, which is running on AWS, we will be able to give the agile teams their own masters, their own slaves, based upon Docker containers, based on Mesos Marathon orchestration, and then the teams they can make their own pipeline based upon their own masters, based upon their own slaves. They're not dependent on mono teams, and if they need plugins or if they have certain requirements, they can implement it themselves. The CloudBees Jenkins Enterprise, it's connected with our on-premise data center. So from a technical point of view, that's working. So we did a successful proof of concept at the beginning of the year. So CloudBees Professional Services, they supported us there. These are the things we did successfully. And with an ABN AMRO and probably with an all kind of other organizations, we need to have all kind of approvals to move to cloud. Risk assessment was done within our security community. People say sometimes Jenkins, it's a Valhalla for hackers. So they do rigid security assessments. This was also conducted, and we improved some security issues together with CloudBees. And we have done a pilot with 10 teams, a successful pilot. So now we are preparing the production CGE environment. We are connecting CGE to our internal LDAP to ensure the right user administration. We will be onboarding the first agile teams, and based upon the experiences, based upon the learnings, more and more teams will get onboarded. We will be moving to the Kubernetes version somewhere in Q3 or Q4. And we also will spend lots of effort on training. Because the teams want to be autonomous, that also means that the teams need to have skills they currently don't have. So for example, Docker container skills. And sometimes teams do underestimate that. But we will spend effort on training the right people and making sure they get the right knowledge. Our hybrid cloud strategy. We have an on-premise environment. It's an IBM environment. That was working better than the earlier environment, but still, we're still missing some crucial public cloud facilities. And therefore, we have said with an ABN AMRO, we will be moving to a hybrid cloud situation based upon Microsoft Azure and Amazon public cloud. These environments have been set up last year. They have been approved by the ECB, by the Dutch Bank. Lots of effort spent on making these platforms secure. And we have already migrated 30-40 applications to public cloud. So for example, Jira is running on AWS. Tiki, our payment app, is running on AWS. Jenkins, Bitbucket, we're moving to AWS. Our chatbot is running on Azure. A finance system, which has lots of fluctuation in load, is running on Azure. So more and more applications are moving to public cloud. With an ABN AMRO, I expect that we will be moving to a public cloud first strategy or a public cloud on less strategy. And in order to further scale, we need to do some additional preparations. So 7 streams have been set up to do the preparation. We need to improve our governance. Allianz mentioned architecture. Fully agree with that. So also for architecture, a separate stream has been set up. We need to keep on improving the security on a continuous basis. Currently, the infra budgets are handled by a central infrastructure team. And if you're really going to do public cloud, then the teams or the business owners, they should be responsible for the budgets. We need to check what kind of skills we need. And probably we need more skills or other skills than we have now. And then we need to check how to obtain them, how to retain them. And I will be leading a cloud native stream. So what does it mean? Now, cloud native, that means that applications need to be developed in such a way that we take full advantage of public cloud of the public cloud advantages. But we're defining architecture for microservices and also standard of guidelines for programmers we need to define. The same for serverless development. Serverless development means that teams can develop and can take via AWS Lambda functions. The VMs are spinned up independent upon infrastructure teams. We need to define and implement a PaaS solution, platform as a service solution. So we're looking to platforms like Pivotal Cloud Foundry or Red Hat OpenShift or maybe Cloud Native. And next to selecting and implementing it, we also need to make sure that it is maintained the right way and that we help the agile teams the right way. We're going to do more and more with Kubernetes, Docker. So we need to make sure things are secure. And also for public cloud, we need to make sure that we have the right pipelines in place. And these might differ from the pipelines we have for our on-premise environment. So security, this is not what we want. We don't want that containers, we don't want container breakouts. So what did we do? We implemented the Docker pipeline, also based upon CGE, by the way. And in this Docker pipeline, all kind of Docker images are scanned and all kind of security checks are done. We have delivered the first MVP. Some security checks are automated. Some other checks we still need to do. We will be looking to tools like Twistlock or Akasek to check the runtime environment. And also here, we're going to implement a build breaker. So once all the security checks are done, then the Docker image will be signed. And once the Docker image is signed, then the Docker image can be deployed to test environment or production environment. Once the Docker image is not signed, people will not be able to deploy it. And we will also store our Docker image in a trusted registry. We're going to use Nexus repository for that. Also, this pipeline we are checking, we're using to scan packages, commercial off-the-shelf software. So we take the Docker images there and we scan them. And we have seen also in commercial off-the-shelf, there are quite some open source vulnerabilities in it. So we use it also to have good discussions with our package suppliers to improve the security.